better place. We have 40 days to make our world a better place. We are smart at what we do to make our world a better place. We are smart at what we do to make our world a better place. By the help of God, to make our world a better place.
In our previous class, we studied about books of original source documents and books of original entry. So, and we looked at one of the books of original entry, that was Searle's Journal. As I had said, we have several books of original account that include Searle's Journal, Searle's Return Journal, Purchases Journal, Purchases Return Journal. We also have Cash Receipts Journals, Cash Payment / Cash Disbursement Journals. And we also have a Petty Cash Book, which we will not cover, and Analysis of Cash Book. And lastly, very last, is a General Journal, which is called Journal Proper. So today I want us to look at Searle's Return Journal. Searle's Return Journal, at times a business buys and sells. And when you sell goods and whoever you sell to finds that the goods that you have supplied them with are not the ones that they want, they will return them. So when they return them, there is a book to record that which is returned. And that's how we keep the goods that are returned in a book called Searle's Return Journal / Return Inwards Journal. So we are going to see the format of it. Searle's Return Journal has got a format that is, we have date, we have details, and remember, details part can be called particulars, and we are going to have what we call return or credit note, number. On the fourth column, we are going to have ledger folio. And last column, we are going to have amount involved. That is it. I'll show you an example in some other class. Let's see what other book of original entry is. We are going to purchase a journal. Purchases Journal takes the same format. Business, the aim of business is to make profit. How do you make profit? Through purchasing and selling. So when you sell, you will keep the records of the people you have sold to in a book called Purchases Journal. It has got the same format. So I've explained that Purchases Journal is a book used to record all purchases that have been made on credit. So Purchases Journal has got a column, or we have five column format: date, details, or particular. The third one is a invoice number. Fourth one is ledger folio. And last one is amount. be able to see an example. For example, you are purchasing goods from one trader, A trader, B trader, and C trader. You'll be able to record it, and all of them are going to be on the ledger folio. You're going to have what we call a general folio, and here the total sum of the purchases are going to be recorded on a general ledger. Each and every transaction is going to be recorded in a respective ledger account. And that brings us to the fourth one, which is purchases return journal. Purchases return journal, which is also called return outwards. When you purchase, you take goods from other traders or the suppliers, for example, or the producer. When you find that the goods you've been supplied with are not fit for your consumption or are not the goods that you are intending to have, therefore you are going to return them. When you return them, then you are going to record, it is going to be recorded in a book called, a day book called Purchases Return Journal. And Purchases Return Journal has got same format, same five column format with date, details, but at this point where we add invoice number, we're going to have credit note number. Remember, these are all credit purchases and credit. And they were credit purchases, but now you return. So you have to see what is the number of the credit note to be effected. Fifth, let's go to cash receipts diaries. Cash receipt diaries. So, in a cash receipt diaries, it is just like a diary. A diary is a book which we use to keep our personal information. According to the day, month, it is for planning purposes. So, cash receipt diaries, this is used to record all cash and checks that have been received by the business. It has got a, if you have to prepare it, you are going to have the following format for it. And you are going to have heading which is cash receipt. You're going to have five columns of date. Details. That one you're going to have. Now on this you're going to have receipt number. Fourth column you're going to have ledger folio. Fifth one you're going to have discount allowed. This is because a certain business may give you a cash discount when you pay to encourage you pay earlier. And then we are going to have cash and bank. Bank is for the checks, majorly for the checks, and also there are some people who deposit right to your bank account, or you deposit right to their bank account. And cash column is for all the cash that comes in to the business. We also have the F1, or the sixth one, which is called cash payment journal. sino, as you receive. When you receive, this means you have made a sale. And when you are purchasing, and the money will come from you, it will mean that you are paying out money. So, we're going to see cash payment. Cash payment journal. The format remains. I say this is a book that reflects on whatever you paid after you had purchased. So we have the following format: date, details. Third one, I said we have ledger folio. Fourth one, we have a discount allowed. Now, when you are paying, you can only receive. So discount, receive. Then you are going to have cash and then bank. In the same order. I hope we'll be able to connect next time and have a lovely day or time.